Speaking of the Red Lions, joining us now to talk about what's been a perfect season so far for them is Sanbera coach, head assistant coach and team manager Drew Droque, and one of their top offensive weapons, James Canlas Kwekutse. James and Coach Jude, thank you so much for joining us here on the show. Coach Jude, you've been, you know, a veteran. Sanay ka, you've been so used to winning for Sanbeda. What, you know, 18-0, was this, can you tell us, was this expected at least to have a top performance, a top performing season for you guys this season?
Not at all. Actually, we started the season not knowing what to expect after we lost key players, Robert Bolick and JV Mokon and some of the other veteran guys from last year. A total of 5 guys from last year's roster graduated. So we were completely not expecting anything. No, we just knew that that we could compete with these guys, James and the rest of the guys, but we didn't know what to expect really this season.
Coach Jude, much more as a balanced attack compared to the previous Sanbeda teams. You had stars, Baser Amer, Borgie Ermida, Babam Gabalinda. I can name everybody off the list. Last year, Mokon and the Bolik, but now it's more of a balanced attack. What was, you know, the principles and the philosophy for Sanbeda this year to have this unblemished record?
Well, it's always been our solid defense under Coach Boyet. That's his emphasis, really. The way we play defense, it all starts from that. As far as our offense goes, we just happen to have maybe some of the top talents in the league right now. And plus, we have a really good point guard in Evan Nelly, who has been a terrific passer. And then he's got guys like James, Calvin, Octana, Clint Doligues, who are good shooters. So it's a great mix that we have.
James, can you tell us more about your the work that you put in? It's only your second year, but your game has really, you know, exceeded expectations. But how is it like for you now to be on a winning team such as this season?
Well, honestly, like, all the hard work paid off. Early morning workouts, me and Yvonne, Calvin Oftana, Prince, everything's paying off. Like, you know, Sanbeda is a winning team, so we just gotta always like compete every time we play. So I give credits to like the coaches and everybody who support us.
During the start of the season, Coach Jude said it best. You guys didn't know what to expect after graduating alpha scorers in Bolik and Mokon, and you were tasked to carry the offensive load. Can you tell us what was going on through your mind at least before the start of the season? Was there anything? Was there any pressure? Was there? What was your motivation to perform well?
Well, I just wanted to prove something to everybody, saying how like Bolik and Mokon is one of the stars of Sanbeda, and now they left. Now it's my turn to like show everybody what I can do for this team. And like, it all started when we were playing, I think, against LPU last year when I had a breakout game. I just went off, and after that I went home, and then I just thought about that game, and then I told myself I got to do something about that. Be consistent in my game and everything. So now, this year.
What's special about your team, your teammates this year?
Our team is like, it's not, there's no one star, it's everybody. Everybody contributes. Like, it's not just me, Donald, Calvin, it's everybody. Everybody has their games. If someone plays bad, we still have like 4 other guys or guys on the bench who can step up for our team.
Coach Jude, what does it take to build and continue building and sustaining that winning culture?
It's a lot of hard work, really, but it all starts with recruitment, I guess, because like in the case of James, we were fortunate to have recruited him after so many other schools tried to recruit him. And then, of course, just to continue looking for talents, try to recruit them, and then put them in our system, and then hopefully you know, they can blend well. Of course, it's also a big plus for us that we have such a hard-working coach as Coach Boyet Fernandez. As you see, he's there almost every game.
Even in his birthday, he was scouting.
Yes, he was. So he's just such a hard worker, and his hard work somehow rubs to the players because they also work very hard.
Coach Jude, now you swept the eliminations at 18-0. The last time San Beda swept the eliminations, you were mentioning it to me, was in 2010. Mm-hmm. Not much teams yet, 16-0. Now one of the biggest factors is you're going to play in 3 weeks because Final Four will resume on November 5.
Yes.
How big of a factor is this for you guys? You'll have to wait pa for the stepladder semis.
Yes. Well, we just have to prepare for it. We're planning to have some tune-up games, although I still don't have an idea against who. And then we plan to have some team-building sessions as well. But the training will continue. We gave them a 3-day break since yesterday, and then we'll continue next week.
Is it a big factor, the rests?
I think so. It happened to LPU 2 years ago. They quite struggled in the finals, but we're well aware of it. That's why we're trying to find ways in order to address that. But we'll make sure that the players are sharp.
Now, James, you are one of the fast rising guards in collegiate basketball. You know, you with your partnership with Evan. Our colleagues call you the Bandana Bros, all right? So, but, how special is your relationship with your point guard and how you work well together?
Well, it all started when we went to Vegas for our training. We became close because we were roommates. And the bandana just symbolized, like, our brotherhood. So we just worked really hard. We just wanted to get a championship this year and just prove that we can do it, just us guys, because we're young. Compared to the other teams that have veterans. And so eventually, the stuff that we did every morning, it's paying off now.
James, can you tell us what it's like? Because now you'll get a chance to play everybody, whoever wins the stepladder semis. LPU, Letran, and San Sebastian, how are they like, as opponents? You can just mention it or you can just describe it briefly, per team, at least.
LPU is a really fast-paced team. They always press, always gonna press us. And they have the Marcelino twins, they're really fast. Like, we played them yesterday, so you can tell how they play. San Sebastian, they have Bulinati, who scored 44 points yesterday. RK, he's shooter, he's like the point guard, main guy. Their game is also very
physical. So it's tough to defend them also,
yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, they're very physical.
What about Letran?
Letran, also physical. They also press here and there. But they won't give up because they want to beat us. Everybody wants to beat us. So, yeah.
Coach Jude, advantages and disadvantages of an 18-0 team?
Well, advantage is, of course, outright finals. We have a longer time to prepare. And plus, I guess we have the advantage in scouting as well. But again, disadvantage is, first of all, we need to remain sharp. We need to remain focused. My fear is for these guys to be complacent because they've beaten everybody. And it's my job to make sure that they're not complacent. So that's what we're going to work for. So hopefully the long lull doesn't go against us.
How are you preparing now for whatever outcome it is, Coach Jude? How are you preparing now for next season? It will be the last year that foreign student athletes can play.
Well, it's going to be tough to find a replacement for Donald Tankwa. But as far as our bench is concerned, we still have a very deep bench. We'll be losing 4 guys, but we're hoping to recruit some of our Red Cubs. Who are also doing very well in the juniors division. So we're hoping to recruit some guys from that team. And I'm also looking at the candidates from other schools, from other high schools. So hopefully.
Last question, Coach Jude. I'll just follow up on what I asked James. From a coach's perspective, can be anybody, LPU Letran or San Sebastian. How are they like, when you match toe-to-toe coaching-wise? Coach Topex, Coach Bonnie, and Coach Egay?
First, Letran and San Sebastian, I think, are very evenly matched. San Sebastian is a great outside shooting team. Letran has an advantage inside because of Larry Muyang, but they're very evenly matched. I think Letran can match up better with... San Sebastian can match up better with LPU than Letran. because I think Letran, they need to handle the pressure of LPU better. That's what I saw from the two outings that they played. So, medyo kontrapelo. But I think whoever plays LPU will give the Pirates a good game. But the Pirates should have the advantage, I think, in experience.
So, basing from what you said, pwedeng San Sebastian over Letran if LPU and San Sebastian. What do you think?
LPU and San Sebastian should be very interesting because they can break the press, plus they have a lot of good shooters.
Who has the upper hand?
LPU pa rin, I think, because I think they're a little deeper, plus they have the experience.
All right, so there you have it, the 18-0, the perfect so far this season, 95 designed by the Red Lions. Coach Jude Roque and James Canlas, Kwekute, November 12th. I believe the second week of November will be the finals, game 1. Thank you so much, gentlemen, for your time here on the show.
Thank you.